Construct the class boundary. Construct the class boundaries of the following frequency distribution table. Also construct less than cumulative and greater than cumulative frequency tables. Also construct less than cumulative frequency and greater than cumulative frequency tables. Okay. Now first they are given the information like ages in years, number of children for that particular age. So here they have mentioned age from 1 to 3 and then 4 to 6, 7 to 9, 10 to 12, 13 to 15, like this given. And then number of children 10, 12, 15, 13 and 9. Okay, this is the given table. For this frequency distribution table, we need to construct LCF, GCF before that class boundary, because the given class intervals are inclusive class intervals. So we need to convert them into exclusive class intervals. That means continuous series we have to form. After getting the boundary, then we will prepare LCF and GCF. Okay. So first class intervals. So here class intervals are ages. Okay. And then given information is the frequency, that is number of children. So first I am writing these two. And after this, we need to find the class boundaries. Lower boundary, upper boundary. And then less than cumulative frequency, greater than cumulative frequency. Because we are already mentioning lower boundary and upper boundary. When we are calculating LCF, we will consider upper boundary. When we are calculating GCF, then we will consider lower boundary of that particular class. Okay. Now, first write the given information, that is class intervals and frequency. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 class intervals are given. 1, 2, 3, 4 to 6, and 7 to 9, 10 to 12, 13 to 15. All these are inclusive class intervals. Now we have to take their boundaries, then we will get a continuous series. That means exclusive classes we will get. Okay, number of children 10, 12, 15, 13 and 9. Okay, now class boundaries. So class boundaries, how we are getting? First, suppose if we want to calculate upper boundary of first class, how we will get upper boundary of that particular class and upper limit of the particular class and lower limit for next class. Okay, those two numbers average we have to take. Means 3 and 4. Upper limit of first class is 3 and lower limit of the next class is 4. So 3 plus 4 by 2. Average of these two numbers. 3 plus now. Sum of observations by number of observations. 3 plus 4 by 3 and 4, 2 observations. So 2. 3 plus 4 by 2. That is nothing but 7 by 2. 7 by 2 is nothing but 3.5. Okay. Same value we will get here. Lower boundary, how we are getting? Lower limit of particular class and upper limit of previous class. Average, if you are taking, then we will get lower boundary. That means 4 plus 3 by 2. 4 plus 3 is nothing but 7 again. 7 by 2. 7 by 2 is nothing but 3.3. Since here whatever upper boundary you got, that one only you get as the lower boundary for next class. Okay. Simply remember while we are writing lower boundaries, deduct 0.5. While you are writing upper boundaries, add 0.5. That's all. So now deduct 0.5 to get lower boundary of first class is 0.5. Next. 4 minus 0.5, that is 3.5. Next, 6.5, 9.5, 12.5. Now coming to the upper boundary, add 0.5, 3.5, 6.5, 9.5, 12.5, 15.5. Just observe upper boundary and lower boundary of next class, both are same. So that is like that we will get the boundary. After that, LCM. So while we are calculating less than cumulative frequency, we must consider upper boundaries of particular class, and we need to take from first class to till last class, some of the frequencies from first class to last class. Less than cumulative frequency, we will get ascending order numbers. Then while we are performing this year, descending order we will get from first class to last. Means here last class onwards we need to start to add the frequencies. Now we will see first class frequency is itself less than cumulative frequency for it. Then second class frequency, that is first class frequency plus second class frequency is 12, that is equal to 22, is the less than cumulative frequency for 0.5 to 6.5. Okay, lesser than 6.5. Next, 22 plus frequency of third class is 15, so which is equal to 37. These values you can write directly also, no problem, no need to mention here sum. Okay, then 37 plus frequency of this fourth class interval is 13, which is equal to 50. Now 50 plus 9 is equal to 59. Whatever total value, total sum of frequencies we got here, same we will get at the first class of GCS, as well as if you are adding all these, you will get 59 only. Just observe, 10 plus 12, 22, 22 plus 15, 37, 37 plus 3 is 40, 50, 50 plus 9 is 59. So sum of all those frequencies is 59. Okay. Now coming to the GCF, same procedure we have to continue from last class, and here we need to take lower boundaries of that particular class. Means if GCF we are calculating, means more than this many marks or age, 12.5 years, more number of children more than 12.5 years. How many people are there? We will get by GCF. And lesser, less than this much age, how many people are there? From LCF we will get. Okay. Now, for last class, same frequency we will get as GCF, that is 9. Next, 13 plus 9 is equal to 21. Next, 21 we got here, and this class frequency is 15. So, 21 plus 15 is equal to 22 plus 50 is equal to 37, and then 37 we got in the here, and its frequency is 12, so 49. And now 49 and that particular class interval frequency is 10. So 49 plus 10 is 59. Just observe 59. Okay. That meaning is which are having the age below 3.5 are 10 people, and lesser than 6.5 age children are 22 people. Lesser than 9.5 children, 9.5 years age are 37 people are there. And less than 12.5 years children are 50 people. Less than 15.5 children are 59 people are there. This meaning is more than 12.5 years people were 9. More than 9.5 people were 22. Like that. So these are greater ages and these are lesser ages. Okay. Now coming to the seventh question. See, just observe when we are constructing LCF, we are getting the numbers from least to small, greatest order, means ascending order, 10, 22, 37, 50, 59. And when we are following GCF, greater number to smaller number, we are getting the order from first class to last class. So that is descending order. Okay. Now coming to the seventh question once. Cumulative frequency table is given below. Cumulative frequency only they are given. Cumulative. Okay. Which type of cumulative frequency is given? Which type of? Cumulative frequency is given. Next question. Try to build the frequencies of respective class intervals. Try to build the frequencies of respective class intervals. So here the table is given, runs and number of cricketers. Zero to 10 continuous series only given here. 10 to 20 means exclusive classes given. 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. And next, 3, 8, 19, 25, 30. So this is the given table now. runs and number of cricketers. Observe the given question. Cumulative frequency table is given, not frequency distribution table. Cumulative frequency means that may be less than cumulative frequency or greater than cumulative frequency. Now question was, which type of cumulative frequency is given? So which type of frequency? Here number of cricketers is frequency. Observe the given frequency values and now we said which type of frequency is given. Next, try to build the frequencies to respective class intervals. Now observe the frequencies of first class 0 to 10, 3, next class 8, next class 19, 25, 30. So smaller to greater number we are getting ascending order. Ascending order means given cumulative frequency is less than cumulative frequency. Now for that we will find out frequencies, actual frequencies, okay? So class intervals are given here. Class intervals, that is runs, and next number of cricketers. Here number of cricketers, whatever they have mentioned, that is LCF. They have mentioned LCF. So here first only mentioned that less than cumulative frequency is shown in the table. Is given in the table. Okay, so now less than cumulative frequency. Now we need to find out the frequencies. So total 5 class intervals are given: 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. So here exclusive class intervals are given. In case of exclusive class intervals, class boundaries and class limits are equal. Okay. Now, here they have mentioned 3, 8, 19, 25 and 30, ascending order. So to get the frequencies, see actually LCF of first class and frequency of first class is same. Yes, and to get the frequency of the next class, while we are performing LCF, we are adding first two classes intervals, frequencies. Means by adding two class intervals, we are getting 8 as the result. Means difference between these two will be the second class interval. That is 8 minus 2. While we are performing LCF and GCF, we are adding the frequencies. If they are mentioned LCF or GCF, then you perform the subtraction to get the original frequencies between the two consecutive classes. Okay, that means 8 minus 3 will be the 5 of the frequency of second class. And this is the sum of these three classes, that is 19, and sum of the two classes is 8. 19 minus 8 will get 11. Okay, then 25 minus previous value, that is 19 we have to do. So what will get? 6. Then 30 minus 25, which is equal to 5. Okay, now if you have any doubt, just reversely perform whether you will get LCF this one or not. First class LCF is 3 only, so 3. For second class, 3 plus 5, 8. Next class, 8 plus 11, 19. Next class, 11 plus, sorry, not 11, 19 plus 6, 25. For next class, 25 plus 5, 30. Okay, so just observe, whenever they are mentioned LCF or GCF, to get the frequencies, go through with the subtraction between two consecutive classes. And if they are given frequencies to get the LCF or GCF, we are going to perform addition. Okay, we are adding frequencies of two consecutive classes. Okay, sorry, frequency of whatever first class and next class. After that, sum of the previous two classes and next class. Like that we are doing here also. While we are doing the subtraction, sum of the previous classes we have to deduct from the that class LCM. Okay. For example, now third class frequency less than cumulative frequency 19 given, and to get this third class frequency, sum of previous two classes frequencies we are taking. That is 3 plus 5, 8, 19 minus 8. If we are doing that, we are getting frequency of that particular class. Okay. Now coming to the next question. Number of readers in your library are given below. Number of readers in your library are given below. Okay. Write the frequency of respective classes. Set the frequency of respective classes. Also write the less than cumulative frequency table. Number of books greater than cumulative frequency. One to ten, 11 to 20, 21 to 30, 31 to 40, 41 to 50. And here 42, 36, 23, 14, and 6. So this is the given information. Now for this information, we need to prepare a LCF and the frequencies also we have to find. Okay, observe the question carefully. Here they are given, number of readers in your library are given below. Write the frequency of respective classes. Frequency they are asking means they are not given frequency. Either they gave LCF or GCF. And also write the LCF table. Means LCF and frequency they are asking means GCF they are mentioned in the question. So directly they have given. If in that case, if some cases they won't give directly, in that case what is given we need to identify. Just observe from first class to last class, the frequencies are in descending order. So GCF is given. Okay. Now observe the given class interval. Upper boundary, lower boundary are different for that particular class. So it is not continuous series, means inclusive classes, not exclusive, inclusive classes. So while we are preparing GCF or LCF, we need to take class boundaries. Okay. For inclusive classes. Before that, first we will find out the frequency. Given number of books, that is class intervals. Okay, next GCF mentioned. After this, we will find out frequencies. Means number of readers. Number of readers. And class boundaries we'll find. And then LCF. Class intervals are 1 to 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 30, 31 to 40, 41 to 50. Okay, now coming to the GCF of first class is 42, 36, 23, 14 and 6. So while we are calculating GCF, from last class onwards we will start. Here also we will find out the frequency from last class. So last class frequency is 6. Okay, GCF of last class is equal to frequency of that class only. Means these two are equal. Next, coming to previous class. So here sum of these two classes is 14 and only one class frequency is 6. So 14 minus 6 is 8. 8 is the frequency of this second class, from last to second class. Now coming to the next value. Frequency, sum of these two frequencies is 14 and three frequencies is 23. So 23 minus 14 is equal to frequency of this particular class. Okay. That is 9. So 36 is the sum of these four classes and sum of the three classes is 23. So 36 minus 23 equal to 30. Okay. Again, sum of all the classes is 42. All the frequencies is 42. And for these frequencies, four frequencies is 36. So 42 minus 36 is equal to 6. Okay. So this is about frequency, and they did not ask you to construct boundaries, but it is better while we are writing GCF and LCF, it is better to take boundaries. If those are inclusive exclusive classes, no need to take boundaries. But when inclusive classes are given, then take the boundaries. Okay. So for first class, 0.5 to 10.5 are the boundaries. 0.5, 10.5, lower boundary. Upper boundary, and here we get 10.5. Next 20.5. So this 20.5 here we get. Next class will be 30.5, upper boundary, and lower boundary of next class is 30.5, and upper boundary is 40.5. Here we get 40.5, and last one will be 50.5. Now we will find out LCF. So while we are finding LCF, from starting on the way after, right? Frequencies we have to take, not this year. So frequency of first class is 6. Okay. And second class frequency is 13. So 6 plus 13, which is equal to 19. Okay. And the sum of these two classes is 19. And third class frequency is 9. So 19 plus 9 is 38. Okay, then 28 plus 8 equal to 36. Then 36 plus 6 is equal to 42. Observe here, total frequencies is sum of the frequencies. Sum total number of readers are 42. Here also 42. Add all this, you will get 42 only. 6 plus 13, 19. 19 plus 9, 28. 28 plus 8, 36. 36 plus 6 is 42. Okay, so with this exercise 7.2 problems were finished. In this exercise completely we were discussed about how to construct the frequency distribution tables only, tables. And in exercise 7.3 we will learn how to construct the graphs. Okay. Okay. With this problems, all problems from exercise 7.2 were finished. So till now, what we have discussed, we will see. In exercise 7.3, we will discuss about how to draw the graph for the given information. So till now, see how we are representing data using frequency distribution table, pictographs and bar graphs, pie graphs, double bar graphs. All this we have studied in our previous classes. Now we will see how we will represent them in graphical notation, means how we will construct the histograms, frequency polygons, frequency curves. All those we will see in the next class. Okay. Now just revise till now what we have discussed in exercise 7.1 and 7.2. In exercise 7.1, we were discussed about mean, median, and mode. Okay. Mean is the so these three are the measures of central tendency, and data is of two types: primary data and secondary data. Primary data in the sense, if we are collecting the information about particular information directly, that is comes under primary data. And secondary data means if we are unable to take the information directly, if we are using some other person's information and then further we are collecting the information, that is comes under secondary data. So we know what is mean by frequency, range, all those definitions. Now just coming to mean. Mean is nothing but sum of observations by number of observations. For this we have the formula, sum of observations by number of observations. And it is depends on each value of the observation as well as each number of observations. If we are getting, if we are changing some, otherwise number of observations, then complete mean also will change. And it is always like between greater and smaller observations. Okay. And if each observation is increased or decreased or multiplied or divided by certain numbers, mean also increased or decreased or multiplied or divided by the same number. Median is nothing but exactly middle value of the given data when it is arranged in order. So if only even number of odd number of observations are there, then only one mid value will get. If even number of observations are there, then two mid values will get. For the two values, we have to take average to get the median in case of even number of observations. Coming to mode, in the data which observation is occurring most oftenly, that is termed as mode. Okay. And coming to exercise 7.2, we have discussed how to construct the frequency distribution table and inclusive classes, exclusive classes, class intervals, limits, boundaries, class max, class length, all these. Okay. Once go through with all these definitions as well as whatever problems we have discussed, and remaining topics we will discuss in the next class.